Previously on Game of Thrones.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. He knows all your weaknesses, all your plans, because you have a traitor in your council. He's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing.
We were told we'd be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's enough, Andros.
Northgrove. That's just some shit story for little kids.
I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about. I'm part of the Free Folk. People round here call wildlings.
My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
I hope I didn't make a mistake in trusting you.
And if it isn't Elena Glenmore, you're not still marrying into this wretched family.
I will tell my father our betrothal stands.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot.
Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
If you presume to speak of my dragons, you best choose your words carefully.
Are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Don't think this is over, Roderick!
The foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward. Kill him if they give you any trouble.
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig.
I knew you were a killer the day you arrived. Seems Britt found out too. Now they all see it.
I'm afraid you've got the wrong man. I was further along the wall at
Don't you stand there and fucking lie to me, boy. Somebody pushed that man off a 700-foot wall. You told me what you did to get here. We both know you had blood on your hands. But now, you've killed one of your brothers. You'll lose your head for this, Tuttle. You'll be disgraced, dishonored.
I swear by all the gods, old and new, I didn't do this.
You think I'm blind? Murder's in your blood. There's only one thing to be done with you now.
Hey, Frostfinger. I saw what Garrett did to Britt last night. I was there. My relief was late, so I stayed behind. I saw everything.
Go on, then.
Yeah, he was there.
Then go on. What did you see, boy?
It wasn't Garrett's fault. We were on watch when Britt just attacked him. Garrett had no choice but to fight back.
There isn't a man at the wall wouldn't sell his own mother for the right price. You two are up to something. Some deal you worked out. Or he's defending you for...
Finn's just being a good brother.
I think...
can't watch a man die and just...
I decide what justice is. Garrett killed a man of the Watch. There's a price to be paid for that. Let's go. I knew it was a mistake to make you a ranger.
Rosfinger! What's to be done with him? We're heading to Crusted.
You'll have to find someone else for your expedition. Your man here still has a lot to answer for. Now out of the way, Snow.
Give us a moment.
And then kiss him quick and be done with it.
Garrett, you told me you wouldn't get into it with Brit.
What happened?
I thought you were smarter than that, Garrett. I thought you were going to be by my side at Crusters.
This isn't right. Brit's the murderer. Frostfinger has this all wrong.
What Brit did to your family, anyone would want him dead.
But John...
Is there nothing to be done?
Aside from removing Tuttle's head from his shoulders? No.
But...
You're about to go off and execute a nest full of traitors at Crusters. How is this any different?
Gods be with you, Garrett. We're down a man, so keep your eyes open. Now let's move.
You can go begging to your gods all you want, boy. It's the Axe has the final say.
Do you know how many men have stood before me with false tales of my dragons? Desperate men, hoping for wealth, protection. Liars, every one of them. And I expect you are no different. You don't want to see what I do to liars.
I wouldn't lie to you. You have my word.
Your word means nothing. Not when it is so easily bought.
Shit.
Are you frightened? I thought you'd seen a dragon before. Your reaction says otherwise.
I'm still getting used to it, that's all.
I'm sure that's it. Would you like to touch him? Go ahead. Unless you are afraid. Of course, a man who has really faced a dragon before may have reason to be afraid. Go on.
Not a good idea, Vision.
I'm inclined to agree with her on this one.
I think I'd rather not.
You're smarter than you seem.
I don't think he likes me.
Then you were wise to keep your distance. You claim you saw Drogon. Give me a reason to believe you. I told you I've heard this story before. I'm going to need more than that.
My friend has the burns to prove it. It's likely to leave a scar.
Your dragon did this, Your Grace.
Well, he wouldn't. You must have tried to fight him. What have you done to him? If you've hurt him...
He attacked us.
Drogon wouldn't strike without reason. You must have scared him. He is not some kind of thoughtless beast. He's only a child.
The men who were following us, the Lost Legion, they drew their swords and tried to fight him.
And Drogon defended himself.
So we somehow deserve to be burnt alive because your little baby was scared.
Your tongue is dangerously sharp, sellsword. Why did you come here? You offer me nothing but lies. To what end? You want gold? A title? My undying gratitude? What do you want from me?
Asher Forrester.
My little brother was murdered in front of his family, and our youngest is still held against his will at our enemy's house.
What is it you expect me to do?
We need to hire an army.
An army?
If you could spare some of your sellswords.
Please, if...
I also came here looking for an army. But what I found were the cries of children and people suffering in chains while their masters profited from their misery. My sellswords will help me free the slaves of Marine. That is their mission. Your need is not greater than theirs. These are people who have suffered for years without end.
I would only need a few men. Those who follow Croft could come with me, the rest are yours.
They are all mine.
There must be something I can do to convince you.
As we speak, my men prepare to enter Marine. What they are about to do is much bigger than you or I. Bigger than one family back in Westeros. So, unless you think you can storm Marine and free all the slaves yourself, you have nothing more to offer me, Croft. You may leave.
That's it.
Your Grace.
See them out.
Beska knows the city better than anyone, Your Grace.
What the hell, Asher?
Is this true?
Yes. I lived in Marine for a time. On the eastern side of the city. Fucking bastard.
So you wish to accompany them? You'd help the Second Sons. Guide them into Marine.
I can't, Asher.
This could be our only chance.
Is that what you're saying?
You're really considering this?
They could prove valuable.
We'll help you free the city. If you'll just consider what I've asked.
We can talk about that after the slaves have been released from their chains. I believe that's more than fair. You two will join Croft and his men. Get them into the city, help them liberate Marine, and I will see that you are rewarded. But your uncle stays here. If I find you've lied or put my men in danger...
I understand.
Good. Croft will get you settled in. It's going to be a long night.
Told you I didn't want to go back to Marine.
What the hell was that?
What's the problem with you and Marine anyway?
Doesn't matter now, does it?
Beska.
Get your armor patched up in here. Extra bedrolls if you need them. Piss buckets in the corner where it's always fucking been.
Long time since we had a piss bucket.
I spent 2 years trying to get where I am now. Don't fuck this up for me, Asher. Nail! We got two more.
It's not your leg that's the problem, Roderick. You've got to be practical. You got the best of Griff last time. When he comes looking for revenge, do you think you can beat him?
He'll be angry, looking for revenge.
It sounds like you prefer if Roderick stayed down in the mud.
Next time I face Griff, it will be the last. I won't let him parade around my halls any longer.
I look forward to it, my lord. But you won't win a fair fight.
You can't handle a sword like you used to. So find another advantage. Surprise your opponent. Do something unexpected.
Like what?
I'll show you.
come at me.
Bring your opponent down to your level.
When I attack you, drop down, avoid my blade, and swing at the back of my knees. Wait for me to attack.
Roderick!
Let's try it again. Almost. Again. Ha! Now that's how you do it.
I think you let me. Oh.
My lord, sorry to interrupt.
Elena?
She insisted on seeing you immediately.
Lady Elena, I hear we're to become sisters.
Talia. Roderick. Can I speak with you? Privately. You remember my little brother?
Quiver! Good gods, you've grown.
You could just call me Arthur now.
I hope you don't mind us coming unannounced. But something's happened. I didn't know what else to do. Maybe this was a bad idea.
You're always welcome here. We're to be married. You'll be calling Ironwrath home soon.
Yes, well, that's why I came, actually. Lord Whitehill paid my father a visit at Rillwater Crossing. He told my father you were disobeying Griff's authority and...
And he wanted to teach you a lesson.
As if I'm some token to be handed around.
You mean...
He demanded I end our betrothal and marry his son, Griff, instead.
What?
Lud threatened my family. Told my father if he refused, we'd be slaughtered along with you.
Father acted the damn coward.
He agreed, Roderick. I am to marry Griff Whitehill. That arrogant, pig-eyed prick!
Griff sits in my great hall and acts like the king of bloody Westeros. You can't marry him.
Do you think I want to marry that disgusting pig? But my father won't listen. I'm not going to be the bone they throw that howling dog. I'm not going to be some prize for him to rip open. We have to get rid of him. I can't think of any other way. My father won't see reason.
It's time someone brought Griff down.
We were hoping you'd say that.
You brought your men.
I command Father's elite guard. These men are trained archers, swordsmen, experts in both ranged and close combat. They're yours. If you'll help us take down Griff.
The whole guard?
20 men. My father still thinks they're aboard a ship bound for the Reach. What do you have to lose, Roderick? Griff has been a nightmare for you and your house.
You can't have any reason to keep him around.
Hurting Griff would start an all-out war. If Lord Whitehill found out, he'd have his whole army at our door within days.
I understand your worry, Roderick. You aren't prepared for a war with the Whitehills. I know this might sound mad, but it's the only way. Get rid of Griff, and you'll be free to use the guard however you like. You can finally take control of your house again. Please, promise me you'll do this.
I love you, Roderick. I don't want Griff. I don't want any of this.
I would be happy to.
Thank you, Roderick.
Griff won't even see it coming. My men are yours to command.
Thank you, Quip. Arthur.
Could you give us a moment? You don't know how much this means to me.
To us, I should say. Maybe when this is all over, we could play hide-and-seek in the Grove again. Pretend we're still children. Forget all that's happened these last few years.
I love you, Elaine.
I love you too.
I can't believe it's another coronation already.
Our kings just get younger and younger.
Tommen's not ready. He's too soft.
Maybe that was the imp's plan.
I wonder if Marjorie Tyrell will be there today.
You mean Queen Marjorie? She was married to Joffrey.
For all of 1 hour.
She'll marry his brother too.
Not to mention Cersei and Jaime.
Shh. The Lannisters have spies everywhere.
What is it, Tom?
Remember that warning you'd heard from Roderick?
About Whitehill's contact? Did you find anything?
Only whispers. But your brother's right. Lord Whitehill. Lord Whitehill is sending a great deal of gold to someone here in King's Landing. He's definitely up to something. Something big. But I don't know what.
I bet it's one of those ironwood merchants. Lord Morgrin and Lord Andros.
It's hard to say. Lord Whitehill is surprisingly secretive. They'll both be at the feast after Tommen's coronation today. Maybe you can learn something.
I can't go. Marjorie's... she's not exactly happy with me right now. I've been uninvited.
Couldn't Sarah help? Ask her to get you in. She'd do it, right? Don't handmaidens look out for each other?
We are friends. I'm sure she'd help if I asked her.
It's a good plan, then.
It's nearly time.
Just be careful, Lady Mira. King's Landing seems to have it in for you.
What are you doing out here? There's leftover honey cake in the kitchens.
Have to guard this one. Locked him up in the old storeroom until morning.
That the one who killed Brit? He's not going anywhere. Come on. He'll be back before anyone notices.
All right. Maybe just a quick bite. He's likely to freeze to death out here anyway.
Just sand. Must be the latrine. I'm not sticking around to use it. onions and crab apples. At least I won't starve to death. If I ever find a way out of here. That might be useful. Oh, I'm not getting out that way. Don't know what I expected. No one out there.
Jared!
Cotter, what are you doing here?
I heard him talking. You're to be executed in the morning.
What about Finn? He told
them. Nobody believes him, or don't want to. They think he's covering for you. Some are even saying he helped you do it.
I have to get out of here.
That's why I came. I want to help.
Well, you'd be executed too. Why would you want to help me?
You had my back with Finn. He would have killed me over that knife. I figured it was about time I returned the favor. So I'm getting you out of here. I don't want to hear any complaining.
You're a good man. You know that.
Don't go singing my praises just yet. I want you to take me with you, to the North Grove. You know I can't stay here. I'm leaving Castle Black, but I'd rather not go it alone. So if you're going north, I'm coming with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere unless I can get out of this bloody storeroom first.
I can try and pick the lock, but I'm not sure it will work. Garrett, what are you doing?
Getting out of here.
Coming loose.
I'm gonna try to push it out. You pull, all right?
I hope no one heard that. Hey, can you fit through?
I think. You two idiots, lucky I'm not Frostfinger. Thought you were being sly, eh? I figured you'd try something like this.
Oh, Finn.
Am I glad to see you?
I'm the sword in the darkness. Help me a fellow brother keep his head.
You'll need this.
Now, let's go.
You're not coming with us, Finn.
What are you on about? Frostfinger already thinks I'm helping you. What do you think he's gonna do when he hears you've run off with Potato Fucker over here? I'd rather take my chances with you. And I'm good in a fight. You know that.
Yeah, good at starting them anyway.
You'll need another blade at your side. Three's better than two.
Having another ranger along couldn't hurt.
Till he stabs you in the back.
We'll talk later. Move!
There's no turning back now. We're deserters for sure. We're breaking our vows.
I've taken plenty of oaths. Broken plenty too. Words don't mean shit.
There'll be a price on our heads.
My family back home is counting on me to put things right. And I mean to do it. Vows aren't going to stop me.
They know we're gone now.
Then how fast can you run?
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Griff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
I'm coming.
What do you mean to do? This could be our chance.
He's right. We must hurry.
He's gonna see what happens when you harm a member of my family.
And mine. The rest of my men are still in the grove. They could be here in minutes.
I'll need every one of them for what I'm about to do.
I'll have them here as soon as possible. Let's go.
Nothing. Listen for my signal. I'll strike my cave when I want you to enter.
We'll be ready.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe. Griff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Together then.
Bite faster!
No, I tried.
Get out of here!
couldn't have tried harder for a Forrester.
My lord, please.
I am the only lord who matters here. Roderick.
Help me.
Tell your dog to obey his new master. And while you're at it, Elena Glenmore, what are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you
me.
You? I'd rather marry a dead horse.
You watch your bloody tongue, or I'll give you what I'm giving the maester.
She'll never marry you, Griff.
She'll do what she's told. And so will he, when I'm through with him. You should have set a better example.
My hand!
Don't believe you.
You're a piece of shit, Griff. You know that.
Oh, you got quite the mouth on you, Roderick. You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
I think you need another lesson in humility. Just like your maester here. I've let you off too fucking easily, Roderick. Gives the orders. What are you waiting for?
Kill anyone that moves.
You heard him. Stand down. You can't do this.
Now then, about humility.
Get your hands off me.
Maester, are you all right?
Yes, I think so.
My father will go straight to Roose Bolton. He'll flay you and your sister and your whole fucking family!
I did warn you, Griff.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you pay for this! Is this the man you'd rather have? This crip.
Roderick!
Enough! That's enough! Are you satisfied?
You need to stop.
My eye!
Roderick! No! No, you can't!
Why are you protecting him?
I'm not protecting him. I'm protecting Ryan. When Lud hears of this, don't you realize what they'll do to him? If you kill Griff, Ryan will be the one to suffer.
Lord Vital doesn't have to find out.
You can only keep this a secret for so long.
I want him dead, believe me. But not at the cost of Ryan's life.
Besides, he may still be useful to us.
It's all right, Roderick.
Confine the White Hills to the cellars. No one gets in or out.
I can't see anything.
Cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not until we want it to. Kill the ravens. All of them.
I swear I will!
Fuck you and your queen.
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission.
Obey?
You know what kind of shit-brained fool does that? One who wants to fucking die up there! Have you lost your damn mind?
I am not some animal in a cage.
What in the seven bloody hells are you talking about?
I will not let you bark orders at me.
I'm glad to see you two are getting along.
Warms the heart.
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher.
You think I'm too drunk to fight? Or the fuck
what do
you
know? What are you gonna do? Run out there swinging a fucking... Ah!
Still think I can't fight?
You fucking bitch!
Oh, there we go.
Hey, come on, Beska. Leave the poor man
alone. Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend. She'll get us all killed.
You sound scared, Croft.
This is bloody important.
You afraid your mother will spank you?
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, we're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody show like you
Beska,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
You gonna lecture me too?
Croft doesn't know shit about anything.
Will you stop trying to hit me? Whatever your problem is with Croft, just let it go.
You think this is about Croft? You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say? You're the only reason I'm even fucking here. And you told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you. You brought me here.
It's just a city, Beska.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Come on, Asher. Hit me. Oh, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead.
I'm not going to do that. So what? You're gonna kill me because you don't want to go into some fucking city?
I was a slave! Here, in this fucking city.
I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was 7, my master threw me in the fighting pit to die.
When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started sending other children. I butchered every one of them. After a while, I thought the fear was gone.
But you had no choice.
I did. I decided my life was worth saving. But theirs were not. There was this boy. We used to play 5 stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. That same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly. My master watched as I did it, smiling. I could have killed him for that fucking smile.
That's enough drinking for tonight. It'll only make you feel worse.
I don't need any more men telling me what to do.
I bought my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man. Marine is a city of dead children. Don't worry about me. I won't let you down.
I know you won't.
Why not?
Mira, I'll meet you inside.
doing here? I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend, but then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important? I need to speak with Lords Morgrin and Andros. One of them might be working against my family.
Doing what?
If I knew that, I wouldn't be here.
Lady Marjorie would be furious, Mira. I can't. I'm sorry. I want to help you, but I can't risk it.
You said you'd help me, remember?
And I've been trying. But this isn't going to help your situation. Are you sure you want to risk it?
I have to.
All right. You owe me for this. She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise. Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it? Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira, Lord Garibald Tarwick.
She's quite lovely. Where have you been hiding her?
You're making her blush. Sorry, Mira.
You're quite handsome yourself. I can see why Sarah likes you.
Hopefully that's not the only reason. It's quite a feast, isn't it? Just be careful around the wine. Though I hear you don't partake yourself. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed. Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people and...
Oh, Lord Tarwick!
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
Oh, really?
My ears are not delicate.
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loaves.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Someone caught your eye, Mira?
I have to take care of a personal matter.
Oh. Well, don't let us stop you then.
If you'll excuse me.
This reminds me of the tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe it.
You told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it!
Andros, you're being ridiculous!
Stop dealing ironwood.
Is there no longer a demand?
I can't imagine that would be the case.
No need for such wild speculation. I've simply lost interest. I'm moving on to better things, as they say.
And what would that be?
No. I can see what you're doing. I'm not giving away my secrets just yet.
He was killed. Right here in the garden.
Well.
Wasn't he Lannister?
One of their guard, but still.
Oh, surely they've found who did it.
No, they haven't caught him yet. Not for lack of effort, mind you. I hear they've spared no expense.
It is a lot, but I know how to spend it.
But how did you manage it?
Lord Whitehill trusts me above all others. That's why I'm the only one he's willing to work with.
Oh, an exclusive deal. How good for you, Andros.
Well, I've got my family to consider.
When's the last time you even saw your wife, Andros?
Lord Andros?
Mira Forrester, did you come to poke your nose in my business once again? You have a nasty habit of doing that.
I hear you're Lord Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing now. Congratulations.
Who told you?
You think you're smart, don't you?
That you've figured everything out. You have no idea what you're up against.
Why don't you tell me then?
You think you and your friend Morgrin scare me?
Who said Morgrin was my friend?
Don't play innocent with me. I know what he's planning.
You can tell him that either you both stay out of my way,
or I'll do much worse than drive him out of business. Good day, Lady Mira.
Oh, please, if you'll excuse me. Lady Mira, I'm impressed.
Impressed with what?
That you aren't currently locked in a cell. I trust this means that you took care of that contract. How did you do it, if I may ask? I wasn't expecting to see you again, if I'm being honest. You must have made quick work of it.
If I tell you how I did it, what's in it for me?
Nothing. But I admire the gall. I do believe King's Landing is rubbing off on you. So, what have you been up to? Enjoying yourself? Though I suppose if you're talking to me, you must want something.
I have a message from Lord Andros for you.
And what would that be?
He said he'd do much worse than drive you out of business.
That insufferable!
What did he mean by that?
It seems Andros has already roped you into this mess. If you must know, I've been pushed out of the Ironwood business.
Oh.
All thanks to my partner. Bloody imbecile. Andros is now Lud Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing. No matter the fact that I introduced them in the first place.
It appears we have an enemy in common, Lord Morgrin.
I hadn't thought of it that way. Then perhaps you'll have better luck against Andros and his new partner, Lyman Lannister.
He's working with a Lannister?
A third cousin, to be fair. Whatever Andros is up to, he clearly thinks Lyman can take my place.
Rickard, are you done flirting with that handmaiden? We need your opinion here.
Leave him alone.
Please excuse me.
Excuse me. Lyman Lannister?
Shit! You startled me.
You seem nervous, my lord.
I'm not nervous. I just get clumsy sometimes. I'm afraid you have me at a disadvantage, Lady...
Mira.
Lady Mira. I'm not used to being approached so boldly. But I'm glad you did. I always feel a bit out of place at big gatherings like this. So, what brings you over here? I'm not the best company, I'm afraid. Or were you headed for the wine and I got in your way?
You work with Lord Andros, right?
Well, yes. We do some business together.
What kind of business?
I really shouldn't talk about it. Andros came to me in confidence. You understand? He wouldn't be pleased, I'm sure.
If you like, you can whisper it in my ear.
I suppose I could just...
Lyman! What do you think you're doing?
What? Nothing.
You stay away from him.
Andros! We were just talking.
You were just talking to Mira Forrester.
Forrester? I didn't realize.
My lord?
Let me say this as plainly as I can. Don't ever meddle in my affairs again!
Lady Marjorie. Lady Marjorie.
Lady Mira? That was quite a scene over there. Are you all right?
I'm fine. I can handle Lord Andros.
It's Lyman I was worried about.
What do you mean?
Honestly, that story isn't fit for a maiden's ears. Just be careful around him.
Don't tease me, Lord Tarwick. I'll keep your secret safe.
I suppose I could tell you. If you'll first tell me something about Sarah. Your help could save me a lot of embarrassment. I'd be very grateful, Lady Mira.
What do you want to know about Sarah?
Sarah Durwell. Interesting name, that. Funny thing is, the last Durwells died off almost 200 years ago. What can you tell me about her family? Something isn't quite right, but I'm not sure. You must understand, I can't court a woman just because I like the way she laughs.
I've met the Durwells when I was at Highgarden.
Oh?
They're a small house these days, but very well regarded.
Ah, right. Well, that's a relief. For a moment, I thought...
And now, Lord Tarwick, it's your turn.
Right. Lyman Lannister. 10 years ago, Lyman was injured at the tourney at Lannisport. He took a bad fall from his horse, needed milk of the poppy for weeks, just to keep from screaming.
Oh.
And between us, he's never stopped drinking the stuff. Can't stop, actually. He spent all his money trying to get more. The man can't go a day without it.
So that's why he shakes.
You mustn't repeat that, Lady Mira. I shouldn't even know about it. Besides, Lyman suffered enough embarrassment. And every man's entitled to his secrets.
I won't tell. I promise.
Good. I'd hate for Lord Andros to trace this back to me.
You learned that from Andros?
The man's mouth is bigger than the Blackwater. Poor Lyman has no idea. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some arrangements to make. Lady Mira?
Lord Lyman, we really need to talk.
I know what you're up to. I won't discuss my business with Andros, so please, please, just leave me alone. You've landed me in enough trouble.
Look at you. You're shaking.
It's an old injury.
But there's more to it than that, isn't there?
What are you saying? Either tell me what you want, or go bother someone else. I don't have to stand here and take this.
I know about your situation, Lyman. How you were hurt in Lannisport. How painful that must have been.
You don't know what you're talking about.
It's no wonder you still need milk of the poppy.
No, I've never...
It can't have been easy.
Andros has been holding that over my head for years.
Then don't let him.
Andros was wrong about you, Lady Mira. You're kind. And you should know what he's... I should warn you. Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath. But Andros is doing it in secret. No one knows. Or at least, he doesn't want anyone to know. I told him I'd keep quiet, but...
That army will destroy my family.
That was his hope, I'm sure, but I... It's only fair that you know, Lady Mira. What you do with it is up to you. But I'd better get my affairs in order.
What did I tell you?
I've had enough of this, Andros. She showed me what you've been doing. I'm done.
Lady Mira, you've just made a very grave error. Very grave indeed.
Don't tell me you're afraid of a handmaiden.
You know where you're going.
Cotter?
Let's see that map again.
So you're asking now, are you?
Surprised you haven't taken it from my pocket already.
How much food we got left?
Here we are. Carried. How's the food?
Well, this won't last much longer.
If Finn wasn't eating all of it.
It's not me.
I will have to stop soon. Look for some food.
We're on the right track. This way.
I'll try and talk to her. I'm one of them.
Wait, what? He's a fucking wildling, Cotter!
They might kick me around a little, but whatever you do, don't come out, all right? She has to think I'm alone. If she sees you, you'll only make things worse.
We don't ting. No, I'm a friend. I grew up near Ardholm. You know it? I won't hurt you, all right?
You won't.
I'm one of you. I'm... Oh!
You sure look like a crow to
me. I'm not.
You're dressed like one.
You out here all alone, little pup.
out or I'll kill your friend! Or I'll make him scream first!
Listen! I don't want to fight!
Then you shouldn't have come here!
Please!
You should have stayed behind your wall!
He'll be all right. Won't he?
Stop! Please!
You don't like it! You best hope your little crow brothers come looking for you soon. How's that feel? I think you can do better than that.
It.
Kill them!
It's over! Just don't do it!
What have you done?
She was running away! We can't stay here.
You're hurt.
Come on. We can rest up ahead.
I thought I'd feel better, seeing Griff dragged out of the Great Hall like that. You wanted to kill him, didn't you? How did you know when to stop? I don't think I could have. I suppose that's why you're the Lord.
It's hard to know what's right. You never really know for sure.
What do you think Lord Whitehill will do when he hears? If he truly has a spy...
He won't know of this. Not until we want him to. The gates are barred and every raven in the rookery is dead.
My lord, there's been a message from High Point. Lord Whitehill invites you to discuss a truce.
He wants to make peace.
As if we're that naive.
Maybe this is an opportunity. A way to get behind their walls.
And do what? You'd be putting yourself in danger, Roderick.
We could get Ryan back. This could be our chance.
You're right. Now that we have Griff, we can propose a trade.
A trade? His son for my brother.
Then we have a plan. We'll leave first thing tomorrow morning.
If you're going ahead with this, at least bring the Glenmore soldiers.
We obviously need them here.
You can't mean for Roderick to travel unprotected.
What if the White Hills attack Ironwrath while he's gone?
My lord, you cannot go into an enemy stronghold unprotected.
Nor can you leave Ironwrath vulnerable.
We have small folk soldiers.
They're barely trained, Roiland.
We'll need the Glenmores at High Point. They'll accompany us.
Yes, my lord.
Let Arthur Glenmore know at once.
I'll start making the preparations.
To think that one of them might be spying for the White Hills.
Duncan wanted you to travel to High Point without any protection.
Yet Roiland would leave Ironwrath defenseless.
Well, we'll need an advisor with me at High Point.
By rights, it should be your sentinel. But for something this delicate, perhaps you best take Duncan.
You're going to an enemy stronghold. Surely you want your master at arms. How could any of them betray us? I've known these people my whole life.
I wish I knew. Still, we can bring only one. We have to leave someone in charge of the keep while we're gone.
Duncan comes with us. Roiland can stay here and defend Ironwrath.
Very well.
Roderick, I know I can't come to High Point, but I can't just sit around and do nothing. I want to help. Please, I'll do anything you ask of me, even something dangerous.
Talia, I may be leaving you here with a traitor.
Find out who it is. Find proof if you can.
I'll do my best.
I have faith in you, Talia. I've known Lud Whitehill a long time. He's selfish, greedy, and arrogant. But he'd never kill a guest in his own home. At least, I don't think he would.
I hope you're right, Mother.
Welcome.
Don't worry about me. Focus on the mission. Your family needs you. That's what matters right now.
Welcome.
Don't worry about me. Focus on the mission. Your family needs you. That's what matters right now.
You're my family too, Malcolm.
And I couldn't be prouder of you. Good luck, my boy.
Shall we begin?
Listen up! There are four of these guard posts throughout the city. They'll use them to warn the masters in case the slaves decide they're tired of wearing chains. We're here to make sure they don't see it coming. Therand, you take the north. Pen, the south. Asher, we'll take the east. And Kieran will cover the west. Make the enemy blind. Give the Unsullied a chance to get in and arm the slaves. The rest is up to them. Don't get cocky out there. One mistake, and the man
you remember when we stole that giant warhammer?
Get in, do
from
what
that
you
woman
have to
in
do,
Lise?
And get your people.
Didn't
out
she hit
alive.
You in the face with it?
That's all you
I
need
never
to
thought
care about.
My head could feel any
you
worse.
You got that?
Tonight, any man who wishes to be free may take that freedom from the grip of his master. You will clear a path for them, but they must walk it alone. Justice belongs to the people of Meereen. Do not make them wait any longer.
What does she know of justice?
Is there a problem?
If you can't do this, tell me now. The masters will be judged by the people of Meereen, not by you.
You don't have to worry about us. Just point us at the people you want dead. We'll take it from there.
You enjoy this far more than you should. Kill only those you must. You will both do as Croft commands. Follow his orders exactly, or you will get nothing. Now go. Show them the hell they have made here.
Hoped I'd never see this place again. Tried to run once. Didn't make it very far.
Which way?
There's a path around there. Avoids the main street. Let's just get this over with. What's the matter, Croft?
You see how many guards are out there? How were you expecting to get past them? We'll be caught.
You asked me which way. This is it.
Then we'll stay out of sight. Follow me.
Can you see anyone?
Cover me.
Oh. Been used recently.
What are they doing?
Pesca!
Pesca!
Shall she, Liwash?
Skuda juntas, wa.
Yelwa, Misha. Mayas, Liwash. Shall she, Liwash?
Spalsa, Washka.
Mayas, Liwash.
We have to go.
There's something I have to do.
Pesca, what are you doing?
Do you trust me, Asha?
We don't have time for this.
Just tell me. Do you trust me?
Of course I trust you.
Good. This won't take long.
Pesca!
Where are you going?
Follow her!
Ingidratule, se was hosli wam yihas.
Why are you doing this?
10 years ago.
Pesca! No!
I should have killed you.
Pesca!
I should have fucking killed you.
Pesca!
He was my master. Desor Zoraza. The man who forced me to...
Nobody can blame you for wanting him dead. Do what you must.
I will.
Have you lost your mind? I'm ordering you to back away!
My best guy!
I am not!
Let him go!
What are you doing?
I shoot! You will do as I say! Both of you, take her weapon!
I need to do this, Asha. After everything he's done.
And he'll pay for it. Once the city is free, he will be punished.
Punished by a queen who has no right to. His life means nothing to her. She does not speak for the children who died in those pits.
Asha, stop her!
I will get their justice.
I won't let you ruin this for me. You heard what Daenerys said.
Your queen will understand.
There.
How could... That wasn't your blood to take.
Do you have any idea what you've done? The Mother of Dragons will have your head for that.
Not before we finish the job.
Now let's go.
So when were you going to tell me he's a fucking Wavi? Not now, Finn. Come on.
What the hell is this place?
An old hunting camp. We can rest here.
Until your friends attack us again.
I know the signs, all right? It's abandoned.
Ah.
I'm gonna go make sure nobody's lurking around out here. Don't trust this fucking place.
Fine. Here. Let me take a look at it.
Ow! Fuck!
Just relax, will ya?
What is that stuff? Ugh, it smells like sick cow.
The maester at House Forrester used it on my leg once. Not sure what it is, actually.
Do you even know what you're doing?
Hold that there.
You almost done.
Oh, God. Does it have to be so tight?
It does if you don't want to bleed to death.
Yes, maester. Oh. Oh, you got anything to drink?
This far north and I still have to fetch the fucking wine.
Some water or something, please.
I'll see what I can find. Whoever was living here must have left. Too bad they didn't leave anything behind. Someone's still living here. Oh, I've seen this before.
Don't move. I'm warning you. Or I'll gut you like a fucking fish. You do look like a sad little fish, don't you? That happened a lot. I can fix it for you.
But my friend is hurt. We're just looking for a place to rest.
There are others with you.
Step back! Want to kill it yourself, or should I do it?
Garrett!
Drop your weapon!
Is that...
Garrett!
You're outnumbered. You can't fight all of us.
Cotter!
Oh, Sylvie.
You're alive!
Who's this fucking Snowball?
I told you I'd come back.
Who are these people?
They're friends.
Right.
You're planning on introducing this Cotter?
Right. This is my sister, Sylvie. She's the reason I brought you here. She can take us to the North Grove.
Lord Roderick, Lady Alyssa.
Gwyn?
And Arthur Glenmore. I don't recall you being invited.
Yet here I am.
Roderick, may I have a word? What were you thinking? Bringing those soldiers here is sure to set my father off. As if he needs more excuses. I thought you knew better.
The Glenmores have sided with us. I want him to know it.
I need you to cooperate today, Roderick.
And why would I do that?
I heard what happened with Griff.
You did?
How you refused to submit to him. You're too strong-headed, Roderick. My father's convinced you mean to rebel. So if you value your life and your family, you'll listen to what he has to say. You need to take him seriously today, which means keeping a level head.
I'm here in good faith, aren't I?
That doesn't look like good faith to me.
You have an impressive stronghold, Lady Gwyn.
These walls hold 1,000 years of White Hill history.
1,000 years of bloodshed.
But our houses were close once, and could be again. So much of our history has been lost.
Shall we get on with it?
The Great Hall is this way.
Are your soldiers expecting trouble?
They're ready for anything. The way they see it, the enemy is within their walls.
What's this?
M'lady?
Give us a moment.
Is this your family?
Shortly before Griff was born.
These your brothers?
The eldest three, yes. Carl died of grayscale a few years ago. Ebbets at the Citadel. Torren serves Roose Bolton. And Griff, of course, wasn't born yet.
Your father doesn't smile much, does he?
He used to, when my mother was still alive.
Is that your mother?
Yes. Though I hardly remember her. She died not long after this was made.
That must be you.
A much younger me. Yes.
You look a bit like your mother now.
My brothers were never kind to Griff. He was boastful, gullible, and quick to anger. But my father always defended him. A White Hill is a White Hill, he'd say. Come on, we mustn't keep my father waiting.
Where's your father?
Strange. I'll go find him.
I don't like this.
Don't show fear. That's what he wants.
Ryan for Griff, that's still our plan.
If anyone here should be afraid, it's Whitehill.
Agreed.
Let's have a look around, see what we find. Mother, look at this. This ironwood's cracked.
I'm not surprised. The White Hills were never any good at the craft.
Oi! Step away from that!
What's Lord Whitehill planning?
He said he wanted a truce. And I believed it. I hope I wasn't a fool.
Remember what I said? No fear.
Right.
Just follow my lead and we'll be fine.
That's far enough!
If this goes badly, what do you want us to do?
Just find my brother and get him home.
I'll do my best. And if it does come to violence, move to the walls and get behind my men.
Bart, on the other side.
Welcome to High Point.
Lord, my men say you've been acting a bit tense.
You're not nervous, are you?
You kept us waiting, Lord.
What can I say? I lost track of time. And besides, you had these Glenmore soldiers to keep you company.
Father, please. Can we just get on with this?
Well? Why? You know, your father once called High Point a keep for the gods. What stonework, he said. What craftsmanship. He wouldn't stop talking about it. If you ask me, I'd say he was envious.
Hasn't aged well, though, has it?
Stone crumbles, but at least it doesn't burn.
Lud, where's Ryan?
Always worried about your family, aren't you? Let's toast to family! Won't you toast with me, Roderick? As a symbol of our goodwill.
To family.
To family.
Now, tell us why we're here.
The Ironwood business is thriving, Roderick. In fact, the Boltons want weapons faster than we can make them. And when Roose Bolton wants something, I like to give it to him.
So, in other words, you need our help.
Don't be so damn full of yourself. You foresters are headed for destruction. Yet, you know more about Ironwood than any house in the realm. Would be a shame for all that knowledge to be lost. Help me craft ironwood for the Boltons, and I'll make sure you foresters survive.
That's absurd.
If you think you can threaten us...
I'm not threatening. I'm offering.
So you're proposing an alliance?
An alliance? I said nothing of the sort.
He'd make us his slaves.
Roderick, this could save your house.
I'd consider an alliance.
You see what I have to put up with?
Just give him time. I told
you... I offer you peace, and you spit at it. I offer opportunity, and you demand more. I've seen this coming since you refused to kiss my ring. Here's how it's gonna go, Roderick. Either you agree to my terms, or I'll have Griff tear Ironwrath to the ground. He'll put it to the torch.
This isn't the way to get what you want.
Then begin slaughtering your small folk.
Griff's no longer in charge of Ironwrath.
What are you talking about?
He's locked in our darkest cellar along with your entire fucking garrison.
You didn't.
You've imprisoned my son. He was there by order of the Warden of the North.
Roderick, how could you?
Now it's my turn to propose a deal. Your son Griff for my brother Ryan.
We want Ryan back, and we want him today.
Bring the boy!
Ryan!
Mother! Roderick! I thought you'd forgotten about...
No! Father, no!
What are you doing?
Imprisoned by flesh and blood. Mine!
Let him go!
He's not going anywhere!
Listen to her!
Let him go, or I'll have Griff
killed! This is not what we agreed.
Blame him! Not me!
If you want to see Griff alive again...
You think I give two shits about Griff? About my fucking firstborn? I ought to kill you right now! Because you foresters never learn!
I'm not afraid of you!
Just say the word!
Kill me! And we all die!
On your order, Roderick!
Let me!
Everyone, please!
I'll kill you myself!
Roderick, do something!
Arthur, now!
If you want to see Griff alive...
You think I give two shits about Griff? About my fucking firstborn? I ought to kill you right now!
Because you foresters never learn!
I'm not afraid of you!
Just say the word!
Kill me, and we all die!
Go on then! Do it!
What?
You think I won't?
I know you won't!
Don't test him, Roderick!
Because for all your bluster, all your posturing, you care about your son. White is still a white.
You know what, Roderick? You're right.
Ryan, come here.
No. We'll make the trade on neutral soil. Griff for Ryan. A son for a son.
Fine.
Now, get the fuck out of my hall! And the gods have mercy on us both when the Boltons come for their ironwood.
It won't be long, Lud. And when they come, I hope that bastard flays you alive.
I'm so sorry, Roderick.
There it is. The East Watcher.
Now listen up. None of those guards can live long enough to light that beacon. Because if they do, this invasion gets a whole lot fucking harder. Don't drop that.
We'll need to take those two out first. How many men do you think are in there?
Hard to know for sure. At least five, maybe more. To answer your question, too many to fight head on.
Is that a harpy?
Course it is. Those golden tits are everywhere in this bloody city. If those guards light the rope, the fire travels up to the bowl, and the whole city will know we're here.
So we stop them?
Aye.
Come on, let's get moving. Beska.
It's nothing. Just forget it.
I know Dazor didn't go the way you wanted, but now is not the time for regret.
You knew what it meant to me, Asher, and you... It's done now.
I'll take him.
I've got the other one.
Just keep an eye on her.
I don't need him to watch me.
Hey, prove it!
What have you heard?
I just sit outside the gates waiting.
Mother of Dragons. She wants to scare us. But she won't do it. Not unless she's a...
We'll split up. One group will go high and try to climb over to the other side.
What about them?
That's why someone needs to stay down here. They get behind cover and shoot the men up top. Just don't let that one see you. So, which'll it be?
You want to be the leader? You decide.
I'll go over the top. You just make sure to clear the way.
He got the easy job.
What happened? Not important. Keep moving. Quick. Guards on the roof.
We'll take care of it.
I'll get rid of them.
Got it. Go.
Down there? Hey, you listen?
They're still up there. On the right. Take them out, and you'll be clear to secure the beacon. They break through. I'll keep them busy.
We can finish this. Just look at them. Two men. We've dealt with worse. Let's rush them and be done with it.
What about them?
You
you afraid of a couple of crossbows? We took on the Lost Legion by ourselves. This is nothing.
We stick to Croft's plan. Take care of them first.
All right.
Believe you did it.
Croft!
Croft!
Quit your whimpering. I'm not dead yet.
You hear that?
It's starting.
Last. Back at High Point, I wasn't sure your brother would survive the day.
He nearly didn't.
I was terrified when you called Lud's bluff, but you knew exactly what you were doing. And now Ryan will be coming home. He'll sleep in his bed, eat at our table. He'll be right here, where he belongs.
We'll celebrate once Ryan has returned safely. You still need to make the trade.
You're right, of course. Still, you did well today. Don't lose sight of that.
My lord, look!
Where are the guards?
Dahlia? Sir Ryland!
Where's my sister? Elena!
Where's anybody? Wait here.
Come on. Don't be so dreary. It was a joke.
I'm sorry, I should have laughed.
Or maybe you think you can do better.
Of course not. I didn't mean to offend.
Perhaps a song instead. I hear you've written a touching song about your dead brother. Am I in it? Let's hear it, shall we?
No.
No?
I won't.
I want you to...
Roderick!
Roderick! Welcome back.
State your business now.
I thought you'd have more courtesy. Especially after getting to know your sister. We've had a lovely time together. Haven't we, Talia? Say it. Say it's been lovely.
It's been lovely.
And you? I'm told you're a man who can't be broken. I've decided to come see for myself. Ethan was the first forester I killed. Doesn't have to be the last.
You don't know what you're in for, Garrod. What you're asking my brother to do. The North Grove isn't what you think it is.
You claim to be a leader, yet your own people do not respect you.
But we did as you commanded!
These aren't sellswords, Asher. They're killers.
Roderick!
I can't believe I trusted him.
I know you and my brother were in contact. Perhaps he told you things. Things that might prove his guilt. Perhaps you're not to be trusted either.
Oh, you're not listening, Garrod.
Shh!